architect. I created the Matrix. I've been waiting for you.
Why am I here?
I don't understand it.
There are only two possible explanations.
There were five ones before me.
Everything was done as it was supposed to be done.
Either no one told me,
or no one knows.
That's impossible. The prophecy tells us.
It was a lie, Morpheus. Then why didn't you tell me about the architect? Why didn't you tell me about Zion and the ones before me? Why didn't you tell me the truth?
Because it wasn't time for you to know.
Who decided it wasn't time?
You know who.
I will not stand here and do nothing. I will not wait here to watch them die.
Choice. The problem is choice.
Sorry.
The architect told me that if I didn't return to the source, Zion would be destroyed by midnight tonight.
Please.
Please.
You and I may not be able to see beyond our own choices, but that man can't see past any choice.
I have since come to understand that the answer eluded me because it required a lesser mind, or perhaps a mind less bound by the parameters of perfection.
He doesn't understand them. He can't. To him, they are variables in an equation.
If I am the father of the Matrix, she would undoubtedly be its mother.
That's his purpose, to balance the equation.
What's your purpose?
To unbalance it.
Hope. It is the quintessential human delusion, simultaneously the source of your greatest strength and your greatest weakness.
That you are in love.
I'm not letting go. I can't.
Can you tell me what you would give to hold on to that connection?
Anything.
You give me Neo, or we all die right here, right now.
You are really ready to die for this man.
Believe it.
It is remarkable how similar the pattern of love is to the pattern of insanity.
I should have known he'd send his bitch first.
Neo, it's Bane. He's psychotic.
Nothing this weak is meant to survive.
What do you want?
I want what you want. Yes. That's it, Mr. Anderson. Look past the flesh. Look through the soft gelatin of these dull cow eyes and see.
It's impossible.
Not impossible. Inevitable. Goodbye, Mr. Anderson.
I wish you could see yourself, Mr. Anderson. Helpless. Pathetic.
You can't stop me!
The power of the One extends beyond this world. It reaches from here all the way back to where it came from.
Where?
The Source. That's what you felt when you touched those sentinels. But you weren't ready for it. You should be dead, but apparently you weren't ready for that either.
I need time.
You believe you're fighting for something, for more than your survival?
You're a symbol for all of your kind, Mr. Anderson. I'm Messiah.
I can see you.
We're over the fields, aren't we?
How do you know that?
I can feel them.
reach the Machine City. And if he does, I don't know what he can do to save us.
Illusions, Mr. Anderson. Vagaries of perception. Temporary constructs of a feeble human intellect trying desperately to justify an existence that is without meaning or purpose.
You've never believed in the One.
I still don't. If you tell me we'll make it, I'll believe you.
We'll make it.
Then why are you doing this?
I believe in him.
I can't. Not without you.
You will. I believe it. I always have.
And all of them as artificial as the Matrix itself. Although, only a human mind could invent something as insipid as love.
I'm scared, Trent.
So am I.
Why, Mr. Anderson? Why? Why do you persist?
If there is an answer, there's only one place you're going to find it.
Where?
You know where.
I know what I have to do.
You're going to do something. You better do it quick.
What is he?
He is you. Your opposite. The negative. The result of the equation trying to balance itself out.
And if I can't stop him?
The future of both worlds will be in your hands.
It ends tonight.
Or in his.
You like what I've done with the place?
Neo.
He fights for us.
Mr. Anderson, I've been looking for you. Is just going to watch. Done with you, Mr. Anderson. You're going to die.
Thank you. That isn't going to work. My power has grown as well, Mr. Anderson. This is my world, Mr. Anderson! My world!
Hi, I'm Andy Wachowski.
And I'm Larry Wachowski.
Or rather, these are the digital projections of our mental selves.
First of all, congrats on reaching the final stage of this game. You kick ass.
Yes. We salute your excellence on the gaming field.
Now, the real reason we're here is to discuss the big problem we faced in turning these three movies into a video game. You see, at this point in the story, Neo stands on the verge of Satori, ready to resolve the paradox of choice and choicelessness, of free will versus fate, but that can only be achieved through an act of surrender, which occurs after he has abandoned the perspectival nature of truth, accepting the totality of present consciousness, which ultimately allows an evolutionary transition, transcending the Cartesian dilemma through the emergence of delimited spirit, which then provides a world with a choice of a third path, the path of Neo, the path of peace.
You promised you wouldn't do that.
Shit. Sorry.
I think what my brother's trying to say is, at this point, it's martyr time. Now, maybe that works in a movie, but in a video game, the Jesus thing is, well...
lame.
Really lame. If you're like us, then right now you're ready for 15 minutes of sweaty-palmed, button-pushing action to kick the crap out of some big badass boss.
So we suggested to Chinee that we change the ending.
We thought it would be cool after Smith rose up screaming, "It's my world," the other Smiths jumped onto him, merging into one massive monster mega-Smith.
So if you're ready, it's time for a little Hulk versus Galactus action.
Good luck!
You'll need it.
And enjoy enlightenment!